Hey guys, this is Deepu. Welcome to the second episode of Overclocking AMD FX6300. You don't see the old casing, right? Which I had used in the last episode. If you haven't seen that video, you can check it from here. In the last episode, I successfully overclocked it to 4.3 GHz and the temperature was 76 degrees Celsius. Yeah, I know, it was pretty hot. As I have realized, this processor has too much overclocking potential. I had to act on it. To overclock this processor furthermore, we need two most important things. One is a beefy air cooler, because I don't like AIO and water cooler because it's problematic, and if it gets wrong, it will mess up your system. And secondly, a beefy power supply. So I have chosen my primary casing for that. It already had a beefy power supply, which is a Thermaltake Tough Power 750 watt power supply, and a beefy air cooler from Deepcool, which is Gamax 400, and it's working very well in this system. As you guys already know, I am a broke gamer, so I don't have much money to spend on my projects. So I have to shuffle through my stuff to get most out of it. To do this project for you guys, I needed to swap out my existing computer and install AMD FX6300 and the motherboard into this casing. It's working really well, and I had to modify a few things to get the most performance out of this processor.
Thank you.
as you guys can see, I'm running this computer at 4.7 gigahertz and the max temperature is about 55 degrees Celsius when I am recording my screen here with OBS. I was able to push this processor to 4.8 gigahertz, but it wasn't stable. As 4.8 gigahertz is not stable, we are going with 4.7 gigahertz and it's looking awesome. I have some very surprising results for you. Get ready for that. To achieve this clock speed, I have to increase the CPU voltage to 150 millivolt and it is quite stable. Remember, when you increase the voltage of your processor, it will generate more heat. You can see here, the AMD FX 6300 is in the middle and the score, the multi-core score of this processor is 560 points and the single core score is about 112 points. When I compare this processor with Core i5-7400, it beats Core i5-7400 at multi-core score. You can see here, Core i5 7th generation 7400 multi-core score is 526 points and single core score is about 138 points. Our FX 6300 beats Core i5 7400 at multi-core score of about 34 points. Yeah, 34 points. It beats Core i5 7400 on multi-core performance. Here you can see Core i5 beats FX 6300 at single core performance because Intel has always been better at single core performance. If we also compare this processor with Core i5 7500, which has 574 points, it has only 14 points better than our FX 6300. If you guys look closely at Cinebench OpenGL benchmark result, the Core i5 7400 got about 94 points and our FX 6300 got 92 points. So it's going neck and neck. Just because Intel has better single core performance, OpenGL benchmarks will always favor Intel processors. Here you can also see that our FX 6300 is not that far behind, only 2 points behind from Intel i5 7400. So it's better on gameplays too. And if you guys play modern DirectX 12 or Vulkan API games, it will perform much better from this processor. Because DirectX 12 and Vulkan API can use multi-core processor more efficiently than DirectX 11 or OpenGL. As you guys can see, this processor performs well equal to Core i5 7th generation processor. And as I can say, it's looking quite well. These benchmark results I got from the YouTube channel Ebony Oli. So the link will be given in the description below. You guys can check him out. He has some great content. So guys, what do you think about this performance? Is it good enough? Let's say I bought this processor and motherboard combo only for 3300 taka. Yes, only for 3300 taka. The seller was holding his ground for 3500 taka, but when I got there and talked to him, he gave me 200 taka discount. So I got this motherboard and processor for only 3300 taka. If we convert it to dollars, 3300 divided by 80 is about $41. So tell me that if you can get a Core i5 7th generation processor performance from a $41 motherboard and processor combo, isn't that great? Yeah, it is. And you have to bear the noise a little. So it's very noisy. The fan gets whoosh, ramped up. So you have to bear with that. But in other sense, it's looking quite good. So guys, if you like this video, a thumbs up will be appreciated, and don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell icon. It means a lot. See you guys in the next one.